symbol table, error detection, code and recovery. So this is lecture 6th of 6th. So here we will discuss about the error detection and recovery of the different phases of a compiler. The first phase we will discuss about lexical phase. Here we will discuss how error is detected. These errors are detected during the lexical phase. The typical errors are exceeding the length of identifier or memory constant. Second, it can be appearance of illegal character. Third, it can be unmatched string. For an example, here you can see if you write the statement printf in C language in double quote parentheses Institute of Technology semicolon and dollar. Then this is a lexical error since illegal character dollar appears at the end of the statement. Second, this is comment. If we are right like this asterisk slash, so this is a lexical error since end of the comment is present but beginning is not present. So how error recovery can be done? Error recovery can be done by the first method, that is the panic mode recovery. In this method, successive character from the input symbols input are removed one at a time until a designated set of synchronizing token is found. The synchronizing token are delimiters such as semicolon or curly brace close. Advantage is that it is easy to implement and guarantee not to go to the infinite loop. Disadvantage is that a considerable amount of input is skipped without checking it for the additional errors. Synthetic phase errors. So in synthetic phase, how error is detected? These errors are detected during the syntax analysis phase. Typical syntax errors are error in a structure, missing operator, misspelled keyword, unbalanced parentheses, etc. For an example, if I write a switch statement, the spelling of switch is here wrong. So switch, user is trying to write the switch in parenthesis ch curly brace open. The keyword switch is incorrectly written as a switch. Hence, unidentified keyboard identified error occurs must be displayed. So in case of error recovery, error recovery can be done by the panic mode recovery. It is already discussed in the lexical phase error, so I am not repeating here. The second method in this phase, we can recover it by statement mode. In this method, when a parser encounters an error, it performs a necessary correction on the remaining input so that the rest of the input statement allow the parser to ahead. Second, the correction can be deletion of extra semicolon, replacing comma or by semicolon, or inserting missing semicolon. While performing correction, at most care should be taken for not going in infinite loop. The disadvantage is that it finds difficult to handle situation where actual error occurred before point of detection. The third method in case of error recovery is error production. If user has knowledge of the common error that can be encountered, then these errors can be incorporated by augmented grammar with error production that generate errorness constructs. If this is used, then during parsing, appropriate error message can be generated and parsing can be continued. Disadvantage is that it is difficult to maintain. The fourth one is global correction. In this, the parser examines the whole program and tries to find the closest match for it, which is error-free. The closest match program has less number of instruction deletion and change of tokens to recover the errorless input. Due to high time and space complexity, this method is not implemented practically. The third type of error was the semantic error. Semantic of a language provide meaning to its constructs like token syntax structure. Semantic help interpret symbols, types and relation with each other. The semantic analysis judges whether the syntax structured constructs in the source program derives any meaning or not. So context-free grammar and semantic rule becomes a syntax-directed definition. For example, if I write like this, int a equal to the value in double quote. So value is here a string. The string cannot be stored in the integer variable. So it does not have any kind of meaning. So this is semantic error. So it should not issue an error in lexical and syntax analysis phase, as it is lexically and structurally correct, but it should generate a semantic error as the type of assignment differs here. These rules are set by the grammar of the language and evaluated in semantic analysis. The following tasks should be performed in semantic analysis: scope resolution, type checking, array bound checking. The semantic errors can be type mismatch, undeclared variable, reserved identifier misuse, multiple declaration of variable in a scope, accessing an out of scope variable, actual and formal parameter mismatch, etc. The errors are detected during the semantic analysis phase. Typically, semantic errors are incompatible type of operands, undeclared variable, not matching of actual argument with the formula. For an example, if I write int a in square bracket 10 comma b semicolon dot 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 with a assignment operator b, it generates a semantic error because incompatible type. So a is an array here, so a in basically interpreted as a pointer, and in pointer I am assigning the value b, so the address of a cannot be changed. So it will show the incompatible type error. Semantic error recovery. What happens in SYN? How it can be recovered? So if error undeclared identifier is encountered, then to recover this, a symbol table entry for the corresponding identifier is made. If the data type of two operands are incompatible, then automatic type conversion is done by the compiler. Thank you.